He said, Jermaine coming back.
I said, for real?
People heard you was coming to town, man. Phone been ringing crazy.
You always represent for the Ville.
We love that shit.
People be wanting you to come here and say your favorite. You can't make everybody happy, man.
They hit the target, right?
Stomping Grounds, high school, Terry Sanford, class of 2003. My first cypher was right up there, look. I was like 5'7", high-pitched voice, skinny. Walked up there with all the big boys.
A bunch of people in the cypher. And there's two or three lines that he rapped were blatantly from one of my favorite rappers at the time, which was Cannabis. And as soon as he said it, my natural reaction was like, oh, like, yo, you biting, like, you a biter. I said it out loud, but I really didn't know I was saying it. I just reacted. But when I said it, it was like the fucking record stopped. It was like, ew. And everybody looked like, what'd you say? Cause you know, everybody want to instigate and pump it. Like, yo, what you say? Speak up. I was like, yo, he bit the whole line. Like, he just stole that line for Cannabis. You know that. He's looking at me like, you rapped then. I was like, all right. Like, all right, cool, I was waiting. Like, but really I was nervous. I acted like I wasn't nervous at all though. Like I looked like I was mad confident and destroyed it. It was over from that day forward. Like, I was right over there. We used to live right there on Lewis Street. You know Lewis Street right
there?
Yeah, that's where we used to stay. That's why I used to come to skate rink all the time, because I used to just walk.
Shit.
That was my babysitter. But then we moved like maybe a mile and a half away
yeah.
to this street called Forest Hills off Kane Road.
Uh-huh.
And when we got there, it was like, damn. Like, I had my own room. My brother had his room. You know what I mean? Like, we had a front yard, driveway. It was like, damn, we came up.
I played Julia already?
No, please.
See that? That's why I am.
Baby, we didn't pray anything.
Wu-Tang! Wu-Tang forever God,
no, naked, you know what I mean? I mean, it's sometimes the elements of light in my seed. Hold on, let me go get my seed, hold on.
Cause when I drop my seed right there, you know what I'm saying? I want it to be perfect in every way, you know what I'm saying? Cause the elements of life,
you know what I'm saying?
Don't
cause when we got
that.
The seed, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You gotta be straight, you know what I'm saying? You gotta be straight.
Gotten to this point in my career and realized that, yeah, I got a lot more dreams and I want to go further, but at the same time, I don't want it if it's at the expense of my happiness, and I don't want it if it's at the expense of my sanity, or if I have to become someone who's so out of touch with what's real, the people that love you and the people that you love.
there's a lot of people in Hollywood right now who have been there for a long time and they've forgotten about their small town lives because they like this life better. But this shit ain't real. I had to put blinders on for a long time, focus on career. What suffers in the meantime is my relationship with my mother, my relationship with my brother, my relationship with my girl. Of course, I love these people and they love me, and they'll forgive me and they, oh, I understand, you're so busy. That might work for a while, but I'm at the point where it's like, nah, man, I want to be a better son. Spend more time with my mom, even get to know her better. At this age, I'm a grown man now. Getting to know her now is way different from getting to know her when I was 15. I didn't know shit about myself at 15. Same thing with my brother, same thing with my girl, same thing with my friends. Ultimately, that's what leads to real happiness. That Hollywood shit is fake happiness. Hopefully, I caught myself just in time before I fucking fell into this shit. You totally get fooled by the artificial shit that feels real, but it doesn't last. The real shit is permanent and forever. The artificial shit, you gotta keep chasing it. There was a time when my happiness depended on how successful I was in my career, but real happiness doesn't come from that. At 29, I'm figuring these things out.